Hello, it's good to be with you. I'm Pastor Timothy Jerry, and I want to share with you some truths from the Word of God concerning your personhood and who God is. If you're watching this today, we're calling this Foundational Principles for New Believers. And it's important that when we become a Christian, when we come to Christ, that we recognize that we have to grow. The Bible tells us that we're to desire the sincere milk of the Word, that we can grow thereby. In other words, just as a new baby we bring home from the hospital has to be fed, has to be nurtured, and if they're not, they will be malnourished and not survive. In the same manner, we have to be fed. We have to know the Word of God. We have to grow in the Word of God. And spiritual growth and natural growth are very similar. We grow spiritually very similarly as we do naturally. We have to grow up, and children grow through babyhood. Then they go to a toddler, being a toddler, and then a young child, elementary age, then adolescent, and teen years, what we commonly call the teen years or young adulthood, and then we become adults, and then we grow into older people as well. And in similar manner, the Bible says that we as Christians are to grow up into Christ. God's design for every Christian is to become spiritually mature. You know, if you're a 30-year-old Christian and you haven't grown up, and if you're still acting like a 10-year-old, there's something wrong with you. In the same manner, in the natural world, if you have a 30-year-old adult and acts like 5 or 10, we would call those people that we would know there's something wrong with them. So our goal for you and God's goal for us ultimately is to grow. And we grow by knowledge of God's Word. The Bible is to the spirit man what natural food is to our physical man. Scripture says that man shall not live by bread alone or by natural food alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. So we have to recognize that we grow spiritually by feeding ourselves with spiritual food. You can't feed yourself with non-spiritual food or natural food and expect to grow spiritually. So as the body grows by nourishing it on natural food, the spirit grows by nourishing it on spiritual food. And that spiritual food comes from the Scriptures, the Bible, and that spiritual food comes from time with God through prayer. It also comes through relationship with more mature believers and other believers as we grow in fellowship with them. And of course, it comes through sitting under the ministry, the teaching gifts and the ministry gifts that the Bible calls for in the church. And we'll get into that much later, but we're really just wanting to lay some foundational truths in your life. You know, maybe you came to Christ, and everybody comes to Christ from different perspectives. Some people come from being raised in a church, but they maybe fell away from God, and they haven't lived for God for a long time, or they have erroneous concepts of what God is all about. Some people have no understanding of God at all. Maybe you were a wild partier, and you've been living out in the world, drug, sex, rock and roll, and you don't have foggiest idea of anything about God, and you're just wanting to grow, and you just came to Christ, and you said, what do I do now? So that's what these messages are for. They're for people from a broad spectrum, and we want to ground you in some biblical truth. We want to ground you in some foundational truths that can help you grow in your walk with God. So each one of these segments is a short message to help you grow, and they are going to build upon each other. Today, the first part of this message we're going to talk about is your nature, and specifically how people are made up. The human, the world we live in predominantly, especially in the Western world, predominantly deals with only two parts of human beings, the physical and the mental, or the emotional. But the Bible tells us very clearly that we're more than a mind and we're more than a body. We are a spirit. Literally, human beings are a spiritual being first and foremost. God, the Word says that God is a spirit, and they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. That's John's Gospel, the 4th chapter, the 23rd and 24th verse. God is a spirit. So if God is a spirit, then we're going to have to learn how to communicate with God, who is a spirit. Now, this is the deal. We live in a physical world. Your body, the things you see, are made up of matter. They're made up of the tangible, real, physical world. But along with this physical world that we see, There is a spiritual world that coexists simultaneously with this world. If you've ever seen the movie The Matrix, and if you haven't, it's an interesting movie and it draws great parallels between this. But in the movie The Matrix, people are living in this cyber world where they think they're really living in the real world, but it's really a computer-generated dream world. And people wake up from this world recognizing that the world they've been living in isn't really the world at all. And in the same manner, this is the way people are when they come to Christ. They've been living in a dream world. They've been living in delusion. They've been living in lies and blindness. Actually, the Bible says that if our gospel is hidden, it's hidden to those whom the god of this world, speaking of this being called the devil, this spiritual being called the devil, has blinded their eyes so they can't see the truth. So when we come to Christ, our eyes are open and we begin to recognize and waken to the reality of the world around us. And of course, first and foremost, that reality has to start with God, a spirit. God, a spirit, created all human matter. He created this world. God said, "Let there be light," and there was God, light. God created the physical world that we see. Well, how did God create it? He didn't take a tree and create the world with a tree because there was none. God took the realm of the spirit that we cannot see and out of it brought forth things we can see. Now, that sounds really deep and complicated, but we know that God created the heavens and the earth. This almighty, powerful being created you. So the first and foremost desire within the human being is to know our Creator. And as a Christian, we come into a relationship with God who is a spirit. So the first thing we have to recognize is that if God is a spirit, then how do I communicate with this God who is a spirit? If God is a spirit, then how do I grow spiritually? So when we talk about growing spiritually, how do I do that? And that's what we're focusing on. So when we think of spiritual beings, you can't see spiritual beings with your physical eyes. These eyes are not designed to see spiritual beings. But we do have eyes that are beyond the natural. They're called the spiritual eyes. So the Bible tells us that when we die, our body goes into the ground, but our spirit returns to God who made it. When you go to a funeral and you stand and look at a coffin, the person that died is not in that body anymore. That body is simply an earth suit. Just like this shirt I'm wearing today, if I were to take this off, it would fall to the ground lifeless because the only thing that animates this shirt and gives it life is me living in it. And in the same respect, the only thing that gives your body life is your spirit living within it. So if your spirit leaves your body is going to fall onto the ground dead. It has no life. And as a matter of fact, within a few hours, it's going to immediately begin to decompose because the only thing that gives this spirit, this body life, is your spirit. So physical death technically is when your spirit leaves your body. This is why many people have had what we call afterlife experiences where they're looking down on their body and they can see people operating on them. They can see people crying. They can see themselves because their spirit has left their body. Now, the reality, of course, is if you are a believer and your spirit leaves your body, you're going to be with Christ. If you're not a believer, if you haven't surrendered your life to Christ, if you haven't been what the Bible calls born of God or born again, you're not going to go to be with God. You're going to, unfortunately, go to hell. And we have testimony of people that left their body. They didn't see a great light. They didn't go to be with God, but they descended into the lake of fire. And some people were rescued from that. They were brought back to life, and it was a horrifying experience. But we don't want to get into that too much today. But the Bible says that God is a spiritual being, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. And so as Christians, we are growing up into Christ. We are learning how to live in a world that is not only a natural world, but a world that is surrounded by spiritual beings as well. And so that we learn how to operate from a spiritual perspective rather than just a physical and natural perspective. Because if we only learn to operate from our mind and our emotions and our will, and we operate from this body, then we're going to miss out on growth spiritually. So as a young, new Christian, one of the things we're going to teach you in this first part of this series is where we are before we're a Christian, what happens when we become a Christian, and now what do we do to grow as a Christian. So this is part one. We're just talking about this foundational truth, and we hope you will join us for the second part of this, which we're going to continue along this week. God bless you.